Hi, we'd like to talk a little bit today about the Gladiator driveline, the one-piece driveline versus the two-piece driveline, and why you should consider a two-piece over everything else. With the one-piece driveline, you can run a higher RPM because the longer you go on a tube, the bigger the diameter must get. And with us putting low gears in, and I know we use bigger tires to offset that, but still, we normally try to get a lower gear than originally came from the factory. This can affect your highway speed with vibrations. I'll give you an example of the RPM difference. If you take from center to center of U-joint, okay, this is 60 inches for a Gladiator. Okay, 60 inches on a 3.5-inch tube gives you a 3,500 RPM, okay? 31 inches on the shorter tube is 2.75. They only go to 40 inches as the lowest, and it puts you well over 6,000 RPM. So you don't have any vibration issues with a two-piece like you would with a one-piece. Now that depends on your tire size and gear ratio. You know, is they're all modified differently. In order for the RPM to be matched by a one-piece tube, and even then it's not matched, the shorter one, remember, would go over 6,000 RPM. If you went to a 5-inch diameter tube, this is 3.5. So 5-inch diameter tube, you could achieve 5,100 RPM. Problem being, you're still going to go backwards because that's a big diesel tube. And it's so heavy in the middle, they normally are only good to about 3,500 RPM. So it's really a good idea to use a two-piece so you can run whatever freeway speed you want, not have vibration issues. And the one-piece obviously gets damaged by the rocks much easier. As you can see, you've got, instead of just a short distance of tube here, exposed this all the way up. If you go across here all the way up to here, this tube is exposed for about 8-9 inches of this tube. So your chances of damaging it and being stuck on the trail and having problems are really much increased. Okay, from up above now you can very clearly see how much lower the whole tube is, and that almost the whole driveline is exposed to the rocks, where only half of this is exposed, and even at a higher distance from the rocks than almost this whole driveline. This is just fine if you're going to use it on lake beds, forest fire roads, and overland easy use. If you're going to do any rocks or anything like that, this is not going to serve you well. You really need to consider a two-piece. And we have this bracket that's been designed to drop it 1 7/8 to clear the CV from the body, and it's designed with the proper angle to maintain all the U-joint angles to keep you vibration free. There's something you should know on the trucks. JE Reel makes forged pinion yokes for the JK or a JKJL and the JT. So all of our yokes are forged for the Rubicon, and this gives you a much stronger unit where you don't have some of the fractures you do in the cast yokes. So now you can see them in a side-by-side comparison, and you know, it's just, as it showed you above, overhead view, you have so much more ground clearance, and you don't end up, you know, with the problem like this where you're, you don't end up with this problem where you're in the rocks and, you know, virtually tearing this tube in half when a rock caught it. You know, and as I said, on the overhead view, you could see the difference was dramatic. So there's a huge difference between the two-piece and the one-piece for your ground clearance and longevity, and for highway speed and vibration issues. Like I say, the one piece, if you're using it very lightly, without a lot of modifications, you'll be okay. Between the damage issue and the vibration issues, if you've modified your gear ratio and tire size, it's really worth going to a two-piece. So anyways, I hope you guys all have a good time out there off-roading and enjoy your vehicle. Thank you.